race and age. So for race, basically I'm Malay, so most of the time I spend most of the time with him, Shakir, in one room. Then I don't really mix with the Chinese that much. And I feel like very secluded. Then for the next one, age, I'm the oldest here, and the rest are the youngest. For him, then it's Ken, he's 90 years old. And they are very childish. And I'm more very mature, so a bit hard for me to get along, because I always have my own corner. Yeah. And so I hope that I can blend in with them and bond together. So I wish that I can get along.
So what elements that I can identify? So I feel like my race is quite a big one for me, because most of the time in school and at home I mix with Chinese people. So I'm not really used to how my counterparts, which are Malays, living styles are like. So it'd be good to stay here so I can learn how they live their daily lives and maybe learn a few things from them and learn their culture as well. Yeah, so we can build better bonds with each other and amongst different races. Thank you.
So for the first one, the identity that would most impact me is my race. Because majority of my friends are actually Malay. When I go out or like work, most of them are Malay. And I'm also used to talking in Malay language. Yeah, so English, I can talk English, but then it's not as fluent as Malay. Yeah, so this would be difficult for me, as I would have to change my habit to talk in English more. So my expectation for this day is to learn more about the Chinese. And also bond with them more. And I hope that I won't only mix with Shafiq only, because he's a Malay. So I hope I will mix around with Ken or
So for the identities, I think the most impact to me is the nationality, because my race is Chinese and my nationality is also Chinese. I'm more comfortable with talking with Chinese and talking to others always using Chinese. So in my school life, doing project, we also use Chinese. So this, I think it's the first time using whole English in one visit. So there's a language barrier with us, I think. So another thing is that I think I'm a little bit not used to Singapore culture, little things. The other thing is the race. There's not many Malay in China, so I'm not used to talk with them and learn how to mix with them. So for this, I expect to learn more English and how to mix with every race. Yeah.
For me, I will talk about race because, as you know, I'm Malay. Shafi is also Malay, and we have two Chinese here. But most of the time, we speak in our mother tongue language. But sometimes we don't really get to understand. So it's been a few days, and then we try to turn the conversation back to English. So that's how we manage. Then we can understand each other. So from there, we start to bond. Yeah.
For me, it's religion wise, because I'm a Christian. So every meal, I will have to say a prayer. So in the first few days when I said the prayer, everyone was a bit shocked. So they don't know whether to eat or not. Then after that was done, then we decided to them, it's okay, you want to eat first. So how we manage it. So you have to just be respectful about my religion. And yeah. Next.
Okay, so for me, The challenge was religion also, because me and Shafiq is a Muslim. So Muslim only can eat halal food. So the first or second day, Ethan and Ken cook food which is non-halal. Then me and Shafiq couldn't eat because it wasn't halal. But how we managed to overcome it was the next day, we all cook halal food, so everyone would share the food together and like bond more. Yeah.
Okay, so for me, the most different identity in the question is religion. For me, I'm a free thinker and they are Malay. And so last night, I opened the door and see they are praying. I think I got culture shock. For the second question, I think it isn't cause something like conflict. I think it's just culture shock, so I can learn about it and see.
My final thoughts about this day is the living room is quite hot. I know there are two fans here and I'm only sweating. It's quite humid. So I feel like they should have an aircon here. And some of those study table is outside. And yeah, but overall it's a good stay. I managed to sleep well. Yeah.
For me, my final thoughts are like the house is very good. It has all our basic needs provided. And there's more than enough toilets and functioning kitchen.
Yeah. Okay, for my final thoughts, for the stay is actually pretty okay, but then just that the bed was really, really hard. Then every time, like in the middle of the night, I would wake up and my back was pain because of the hard bed. But then overall, it's okay because I have all my dog mates, yeah, to like, you know, we can have fun during the night, yeah. Overall, it's okay, yeah.
For me, I think the dog is really good. It's very convenient for us to go to the classroom, and but sometimes the lift is very crowded and sometimes cannot get up. Yeah. Okay.